I would definitely consider space food as its own cuisine. On Earth, a cuisine is created when people from a region use generations of wisdom to flavor, to prepare, and preserve the food. And because of unique challenges we're facing for space food, like we need to meet the safety standard, we need to meet the nutritional standard, and the food need to be able to work with a microgravity environment, I think we formed our own cuisine. My name is Xulei Wu. I'm a food scientist by training, working in the Space Food System Laboratory. We create and produce space food for various space programs. I'm the food system manager, so I work with our team and also our counterparts outside of the food lab to ensure a timely delivery of the space food to support International Space Station and very soon Artemis 2 mission. Many people, when they hear space food, they will feel like yuck. But actually, many of our food products taste pretty good despite that they need to be low sodium and also need to meet the safety requirement. They're actually tasting pretty good. Food is very important. Food will provide the nutrition astronauts would need for their health and performance. Food also provide a critical mental well-being to our crew members, because even on ground, we gathered, we celebrate with the food. That's even so when they're so far away from home. Because they're so far away from home, that's why it's very important to send the food that will be shelf-stable for a long time. On the International Space Station standard menu, there are over 200 different food and beverage items that we supply. We do provide a crew food session training to crew members. Once they are assigned for a flight, they will come in to try all the food that we provide on the standard menu. We're trying to make this easy for crew members, so we break into 10 different categories. So in those categories, we have breakfast, where they can find scrambled egg, where they can find granola and blueberry, where they can find their old cereal. And then for lunch and dinner, then we break down to like vegetable and soup, meat and fish, side dishes, and then we also have snack and a dessert for crew member to choose as well. Among the space food we send to International Space Station, there are several major types. The first type, those green pouches, those are thermal stabilized food. They're just like the canned food you can find in grocery store. This type of food utilizes high heat to make the product sterile so that they do not require refrigeration or freezing. They can heat up or eat as is by just opening the pouch. The other type of food we send out, this is a freeze-dried product. Freeze-drying is a process to remove most of the water out of the food. By removing the water out of the food, the weight becomes super light. And once crew member add water back before consumption, that will reconstitute and represent the texture of this product again. So the food we provide right now to our astronauts, we consider as ready to eat. So that means the crew member, all they needed to do is either put this pouch inside of the food warmer to heat it up if they prefer to warm, or they add water. If it's a freeze-dried product, they will need to add water first, and then they can heat up or let it hydrate for 10-15 minutes before they open up and they eat. In the microgravity environment, water is super critical. Water acts like a glue bonding the food together. And thanks to the surface tension of water, that allows crew member to open the pouch carefully and use a spoon to scoop the food and deliver that into their mouth. Definitely a lot of consideration goes into what recipes to create. First of all, we want the food to be tasting good. If the food not tasting good, then no crew member would want to eat that. And secondly, we also want to bring nutritional benefits to crew members. So we're looking at what's already available in the current food system and what's lacking. My favorite part of this job is really to serve a large purpose, that I'm part of the effort to support human space exploration so that one day we can go back to the moon and one day we're gonna make our presence on the Mars. As we're preparing for those longer exploration missions, We're in the process to evaluate the shelf life because for the longer exploration mission, it needs longer shelf life. Right now for International Space Station, we're targeting 3-year shelf life. For Mars mission, we're targeting 5 to 7 years shelf life. So our food scientists are working to see what approach we can put in to ensure the food will still be good and nutritious 5-7 years after. Microgravity creates its own unique challenges, salt and pepper. At home, that's just on our table, salt, pepper shaker. So those crumbs, they could just float. On Earth, they just fall onto the table, fall onto the ground. In microgravity, they can get into equipment, mess with equipment. Therefore, we have to dissolve the salt in water and send this as a liquid salt for them to be used in the microgravity environment. I become interested in food science for 2 reasons. One is when I need to determine which major to choose, I find it's very difficult because I like multiple disciplines. I love physics, I love chemistry, I like biology, it's a hard time. At the same time, there was a big scandal broke out in China. Many baby infant formula companies, they adulterated the formula with a chemical that actually could cause kidney stone and kidney damage. That's kind of the trigger that I realized I want to study more about food safety, and then food science happened to be the discipline that involves multiple different disciplines in that process. I have never thought about landing a job at NASA because I was born and raised in China as a first generation immigrant. Being able to work at NASA is something for me like too good to be true. I don't consider myself very smart. I'm very hardworking, and I think it's important to discover what is your true interest, your true passion, what subject do you love the most, and then connect this to a career that is making contribution to the society. If you run into some issues and doubt yourself to be the right fit for the STEM field, my advice to you would be, it's okay to have a difficult time. Give it a try, give it a shot. Because as long as you work hard enough, you will find out what you're truly fit for. Don't doubt yourself. You don't know what's your true potential. Go explore, go test it out.